Hi, I'm Matt, and this is my dad, Emeritus Professor Charles Griffiths. He's an expert in marine biology and has found a ton of new species. And together, we're going to explore the shore.
Matt, come over here. There's something quite cool I want to show you here. The lower part of the intertidal in South Africa is dominated by just one species, and that's this gardening limpet here. And its name is cochlear, the ear limpet. Supposedly this lobe at the end of the shell gives the animal an ear-like shape. And these are very, very interesting limpets because they're actually gardeners. So each individual limpet actually establishes a little garden of red algae around itself. And that limpet will never move away from that tiny little space there. If you look closely at the garden, you can actually see the little pathways through the garden. And that is the limpet having eaten and trimmed little paths through the garden. And by doing that, it creates edges in its garden. And rather like trimming a lawn in your domestic garden, once you've trimmed that edge, then you're creating a free area into which the grass or the algae will grow again. So it's promoting growth by growing, by grazing these little pathways. And these algae grow very rapidly, and the limpet can obtain all the nutrition it needs just from that tiny little area. And this is a symbiotic relationship. So the limpet is completely dependent on that alga, and the alga is completely dependent on the limpet.
So they look really packed tight together.
Yes, most limpets actually get up and move around and graze on the rocks, but these guys stay in their tiny little territories, and that enables them to actually become extremely dense.
So then how do you fit new ones in? Where do the babies go?
So as you can see, there's really very little space for new limpets to move into this rock here. And so the babies have to start life off by living on the backs of their mums and dads. So if you look at some of these limpets, here's one with two babies on its back, and here's another one with a very large baby on its back. And in fact, this baby's already established a garden on the back of its parent. So the young ones originally settle on the backs of the adults, and then as soon as an adult dies, it frees up a space on the rocks, and one of the babies will move down from the back of an adjacent adult and occupy that space. That's quite interesting. There's its skull where it was, and it's moved off onto the rock and found itself a little space. So in this way, the number of limpets per square meter remains pretty much constant decade after decade. One of the interesting things about these limpets is that they live a very conservative and slow lifestyle. So the larger limpets here are probably at least 50 years old. They only have a tiny area to graze, so they metabolize very slowly, they mature at an old age, and they grow very slowly. There's nothing wrong with that lifestyle, it's just another way of doing things.
So one of these big guys could have been here for 40, 50 years.
Yeah, the older ones can be decades old. This one here. This is another gardening limpet. It's called the long-rayed limpet because it's got these long projections or long ribs on the shell. And it has a much larger garden. It's made out of a different species of algae. So it's a different limpet and a different alga. But again, you can see the little grazing paths here where the limpet has been feeding and created little spaces, little pathways into which the algae will grow. It's a much faster growing species and it needs a bigger garden. So these gardening limpets are found all along the coast of the Western Cape.
who'd have thought that these limpets are out here farming like this? It seems like we discover something new every time we come out here.
And here's my dad being washed away. That was exciting.